Let us pray. Avinu Shebashamayim, our Heavenly Father, please bestow your benevolence on the members of the New York State Senate. Bless them personally and their families with all good things so that they should be able to serve you and the people in the state of New York faithfully as they have until now. Especially if today or lately, the members of the New York State Senate have passed a resolution honoring the Rebbe, the Lubavitcher Rebbe, Rabbi Menachem M. Schneerson, with 114 days of education, commemorating 114 days since the birth of the Rebbe. The Rebbe cared for the education of each child, regardless of race, religion, color, or creed. I heard the Rebbe say many times that he wants each child to know that there is an eye that sees, and there is an ear that hears, and that the world is not a jungle. In 1991, before I went to Washington to open the United States Senate, which is a branch, of course, of this Senate, I went to see the Rebbe, and the Rebbe said to me, take with you a tzedakah box, a charity box, and during your prayer, you should offer $1 into the charity box, and everybody should see what you are doing, and they should know what charity, what money should be used for. So it is my unique pleasure today and privilege to do what the Rebbe told me. And I'm putting in a dollar in which it says, in God we trust, into the pushka, into the charity box right now. And I would invite each and every one of you, if you want, to participate as well. But I don't want you to think that this is a fundraising campaign. Because if it were, we would ask you for much more than $1. This is a campaign for goodness and kindness. You were chosen, each and every single one of you. You were chosen by Almighty God and by the people in the state of New York to be the custodians of laws of goodness and kindness and honesty, democracy and decency for the people in the state of New York. And because New York is such a great state and has influence on all the states in the Union, you also have influence all over the United States. And by extension, as the United States of America is a superpower, you have influence all over the world. So all the laws and all the good things that you do in this chamber are not limited only to the people of New York. They are universal because everyone is looking up to you. What do the people in the state of New York do? I want you to know that every Shabbos, every Saturday, in our shuls, in our synagogues, we say a special prayer for you. We say v'chol mi she'oskim b'tzorchei tzibur be'emuno. I don't want to test your Hebrew, but it means all those who serve the public faithfully as you do. We offer a special prayer for you that Almighty God should keep his benevolence on you and save you and guard you and keep you and give you all the things that you need and give you a lot of happiness and success, not only in your public life, but indeed in your personal lives. And let us say, amen.
Mr. Chairman, I rise to pay homage to a great leader, a great spiritual leader, Rabbi Menachem Schneerson of the Lubavitch Orthodox Jewish Organization. I want to thank Rabbi Butman for coming here today to do the invocation for the Senate floor. Rabbi, the Rebbe, as he's dearly called, affected millions of people throughout the world. As you mentioned before, we have shuls throughout the world spreading the word of the Shabbat. And I just want to say, when I went to Israel, I saw the Rebbe's picture all over Israel. And people think that the Shabbat Lubavitchers are Orthodox Jewish people, but they do fight for Israel. So I saw many of my young constituents from Crown Heights fighting in the military for the protection of Israel, to protect its God-given borders from enemies abroad. I think everyone should go to Israel to see how all of Israel's borders has enemies. For me, it was shocking to see ISIS flags at the border in the Golan Heights. It was shocking for me to see young boys and girls playing in warehouses because they were fearful of seeing missiles coming from Gaza in Sderot. So I just want to say the Rebbe's legacy is still present throughout the world. It's especially present in Crown Heights, Brooklyn, where I represent. Lubavitch have supported me from my first run for office when I ran for the school board. The Lubavitch men supported me to become the president. Mordecai Eckhaus, Stuart Bauberg, Rabbi Abraham Flint, and Yitzhak Washall. So I commend the Lubavitch community for believing in me and having me be the president of the school board. And we had the fifth best school in New York State, the Crown School for Law and Journalism. And I went to Israel. I was surprised people knew who I was. They knew more about me than David Greenfield. They kept saying, Senator, Senator, Senator. But I didn't realize that by going to Shom Zucca on Friday night before the circumcision of the young men that I would be so widely known in Crown Heights, throughout Brooklyn, and in Israel. Shom Zucca is when a young boy, before he's circumcised, his family has a gathering, and we drink bread. We have festivities, and we usually have scotch, and no fights break out. So every Friday night, I'm always going to a Shom Zucca with my Lubavitch brothers and sisters in the Crown Heights community. As you all know, we had the Crown Heights riots over 20 years ago, but since then, we have formed an alliance of working together, and we have created a blueprint that I wish all people could live with throughout the world. What was disturbing to me when I went to Israel is that I saw a man stabbed for no other reason than being Jewish. When we walked through the holy city in Jerusalem, we had to walk with armed security for being attacked and being called Americans and called derogatory names. So I commend the Lubavitch community for fighting for Israel with the young men and women from Brooklyn. And I commend in the spirit of the Rebbe for being a man of vision, of foresight, and spreading love and harmony throughout the world. Thank you.